been two quick games so far, hasn't it? The mixed doubles comfortably won by Belair and Bangil. Equally comfortable for Eric Pang in the men's singles. It's women's singles next. For Scotland, it's Kirsty Gilmour. For the Netherlands, Patty Stolzenbach. Here come the girls. Kirsty, the Scottish teenager, leading the way here. But a young lady with a big future, it would seem. Well, Paddy's had a mixed bag so far at this year's Sudirman Cup. She won against the French and the Austrians and lost against Michelle Lee in her last match against Canada. But three wins out of three for Kirsty. At 83 is Stolzenbach. 38th in the world for Kirsty Gilmour. Yet to win this year. She has reached the quarterfinals of the Denmark International. Won three events last season, the Polish Open, the Czech International, Swiss Open. Touted as well, the future of Scottish badminton since her early teens, really. Opponent, 4 years older from the Netherlands. Semi-finalist at the Swedish International, her best of the year. She won once last year. Plenty of experience, played in the Sudirman Cup a couple of years ago as well. But again, you'd favour the lower ranked player in this one.
Absolutely. Kirsty is one of the promising young European players in ladies singles. This is really one of the events where Europe is struggling is ladies singles compared to Asia. So we have a Spanish girl, Kirsty Gilmour, and a few from Denmark, and that's about it. So it would be very interesting to see the development of especially Kirsty here. She's done well.
Time. Scott's here. We'll be hoping Kirsty can take the point to get them back in front. Well, 19, but she does have plenty of international experience, doesn't she?
I was just about thinking it and saying it because.
Ladies and gentlemen,
a lot of the other
on my right, Netherlands, represented by Patty Stolzenbach. On my left,
already.
Scotland, represented by Kirsty Gilmour. Scotland to serve. Love all. Play. Service over. One love. Cut. Service over. 1-0.
The girls seem to be younger. Does that make sense? You know, in terms of...
Yes, yes it does.
In it's terms of quality at the young age.
Yes. The girls always able to compete in senior badminton a lot earlier than the boys. The boys really need the strength and they only will get it until they're 22, 23 normally.
Could you look at like... we saw PV Sindhu earlier this week, of course. Yes. Tomorrow's semi-finals, Thailand, you'll have Ratchanok in Tanon. Mm.
Yeah, they break through a lot earlier. We had Camilla Martina from Denmark.
Service over. 2-0.
Kirsty touched the net here, which is why the point went just here. Yeah, sorry, the net. I don't think it would have made any difference to where the point was going anyway, though. No.
Well spotted by the umpire.
Service over. 3-0.
Already here you start seeing a pattern where Kirsty is the more aggressive player of the two and then wants to finish with her good smashes. And I think that is going to be a deciding factor in this match.
Yeah, as long as she's on a game, then you feel that again. It could be quite a comfortable one as well, although Stolzenbach has proved gritty so far.
And that forehand flick cross court we've already seen on a number of occasions. It must be one of the favourite shots.
Five, three.
You know, we look at players' form, we look at their abilities, and of course, judgment obviously is based on that. Sometimes players underperform, sometimes they're carrying an injury we're not 100% sure about, and sometimes their opponent on the other side of the net have one of those days where they just do everything right.
I tried that on a few occasions, I must say. You're standing there expecting to win quite easily and suddenly your opponent is playing just like a dream. That's a good shot. Bad luck. I think it was out, but it was a
seven,
very good
three.
Shot. Very well executed.
Yeah, it was just out. Making Stolzenbach really work there, wasn't she?
Yes. A lot of cross-court shots, though.
Three.
And I'm sure she's getting in trouble when she's playing a quicker opponent, like the Chinese. They will punish her for playing those cross-court flat shots.
She's won 6 points in a row, though. Should be 6 points in a row, for the pun.
Starting to sound like me. Maybe I'm
nine. Three.
I'm picking up your Dinglish.
Yeah, Dinglish. You know, the odd mistakes here and there, or quite a few.
Just the odd.
Service over. 4-9. Service over.
interesting that she's been playing women's doubles with Jilly Cooper, but again, we look at the lineup, and if it does go to the women's doubles, she's going to be action alongside Imogen Banker.
Yeah. But Imogen is a much better doubles player, so obviously, from the team's point of view, that's the best option they have, and they partner them despite the new partnerships. We very often see that on the smaller nation. They have one or two good players. Obviously, they will partner them up for these occasions. As what they did in the next episode. Yeah.
Yeah, but I mean, they actually, I mean, look at the rankings, they're 39th in the world, Cooper and Gilmour, but I suppose, again, you know, when you start getting players like Blair and Bankier coming back into your squad after being in England, you utilise things as to their optimum, don't you? Really?
Absolutely. It'd be silly otherwise.
Service over.
11-7.
Interval.
A few mistakes here. Yeah, at the very end, so it's only 11-7. She was, I think, a little bit of tension, right?
Yeah, she was indeed. But it's still a decent lead for the Scottish girl at this interval.
Daarin moet jij proberen, net zo lang in de rally, op het moment dat jij...
Every time it goes in. Okay, when you change side, they say you put a blade around the head. That makes sense, because you want to play shuttle safe. Yeah. So I nailed it, and we'll still play the drift.
Pick one, one. On her. 20 seconds. Hey. One, one. 20 seconds. Seven.
Gilmour is delaying that
13.
Shot slightly there. But Stolzenbach is coming up and playing a very nice net shot. Oh, that's a good shot. That's really good. Good pace, good opening up.
Service
very well played.
14-8.
That's a good shot, this one. That one is a nice one.
See Scotland, couldn't you, being in level one, if they did establish those partnerships, keep them with Blair, the Bankers, Gilmour, Banker. Obviously, Kirsty will be a couple of years older, she'll have a chance to obviously move up the rankings.
But that's why I'm not completely in favour of this new change the BWF has made, where it's purely based on
service
ranking,
over.
I think that there is a lack of incentive somewhere.
15.
For the teams to play.
There would certainly be a greater, I think, I mean, not saying the result will be any different, but there would be a greater intensity to this match, wouldn't there?
Absolutely, and also for the teams, it's important to say we are number 18 in the world, and we are number 14 in the world, and they have worked this ranking for years and years and years.
But again, you want to see the best players, don't you, playing against one another, so...
Yeah, that's the other argument. That's the other argument.
10, you will get 16.
It, yeah. In most cases.
But there's arguments for and against. I mean, with the Dutch, I mean, they haven't got a big squad here, have they? I mean, maybe if they knew that there was a chance of getting promotion, they might have brought one or two others and could have maybe mixed it up a bit more as well.
Yeah, and we see teams are normally very good badminton nations, so I'm not even here, because they say, no, it's not to bother, as you know, we can always go in according to our ranking next time.
Yeah.
Service over.
Yeah, it's a difficult balancing act, isn't it?
17, check.
Look forward to semi-finals tomorrow. Should be good. China got their feathers ruffled a little, didn't they, in the quarter-final against Indonesia.
Indonesia played really
well. Danes just sneak every time, come rain or shine.
Yes, we sneaked into the semi-final. And, but it will be a tough match tomorrow against China, no doubt.
Great that, you know, we've got a new nation in the semis for the first time in Thailand.
Yeah, Thailand 18, they honestly, I think, deserves it so much. They have been working towards building their team for the past 5, 6, 7 years, and they have lots of youngsters coming through, and it's really paying off for them.
Well, cruising away 19, now, isn't she? Kirsty Gilmour.
Going to stop her in the first set here. Interesting to see how she will handle the drift in the second set.
That's a good lift considering the pressure she was under.
Absolutely, I agree. That's good play by Stolzenbach.
Service over.
Very good play. Good pressure.
12-19.
Starting there. Good shot again. Good lift.
Stepped up a game a little
20,
bit here, Stolzenbach, but still
I
think so.
Unable to deny Gilmour these game points. Available for Gilmour here.
Good play. Very nice. Good pressure on the backhand side there.
16, 20.
Gilmour couldn't get out of it.
And three saves. Gilmour does take the first game, although from 19-11 down, Stolzenbach showing a little more of what she'll probably need to do in the second set there later on. But Scottish girl one set to the good up after taking 21 points to 16.
On the chip. change your side now. Okay? When you play to her forehand and rear, it's fine, you need a margin. You know, something, and if you're around the head, that's okay. The shuttles will drift on the side. And also, you know, when you move her, it's very well. Because can mixing up combine. Short serve. You know, I mean, I just off the mark or quick in my third shots.
Yeah.
I mean, that when you're on the fast end, so you have a little bit more parts to play. Alright?
Yeah.
And just a still focus on the drive. You know? Your mobility and movement are much better. Okay? Just only when you're on some time, you know, you're jumping.
Court one,
if you want
20 seconds.
To body.
Court one, 20 seconds.
Straightforward matches so far.
In other words,
the person who took the first
one
set picked up where they left off, carried on, and stormed away with the second two. I wonder if we're going to see that here, although things might prove a little trickier for Gilmour in terms of the side of the court she's on.
She already played the first one too long. There's the game way too long. That's it. Start the attack.
Service over.
Settling on that side as well.
One, two.
Interesting to see if Gilmour is following the advice of her coach. Asked her to sort of mix up the services a bit more, with some high ones and some low ones. And especially when she was serving a low serve, you have to have a lot of awareness on that third shot.
Five, two. Well played by Stolzenbach. She's making the most of things here at the moment. Good start from her to the second set.
Again, we'll have to keep it downwards until she settles in on this side.
She's doing
here. Excellent choice.
Three,
you know, keep it down until she's finding her bearings on this side. There comes the low serve.
Service over. Seven,
first shot.
Three.
And she knows. Not really pushing off.
Service over. 4-7.
Lovely angle on the first shot allowing the winner.
Service over. 8-4.
Thank you. tight net shot.
Betty's playing well.
That's something to think about here for Gilmour, that's for sure.
She's catching up at least two, maybe even 3 points from now until before the interval. That's well left. There's 1 point.
6-9.
She should hopefully, seen from her perspective, try to get at least 8. So there's not too much catching up to do in the second half. There's some easy points here.
Three in a row, just the right time for her. Stolzenbach fighting back, 11-8 up in this second set. Gilmour with her work cut out after taking that opener.
Zij naar haar aan het speelt, moet hij of ietsje vlakken of ietsje hoog, maar nu kan ze eronder komen. Want als je hoog serveert en je ziet dat ze springt, je bent altijd terug. Als ze springt.
Because your defense is a lot better than her. Okay? Now, how can you do the stick smashes around her body? It's
point
she
one.
Made errors.
Seconds. You know what I mean?
If you pass shot,
she's
a bit longer. She can either for her defense.
Come on, Gilmour!
That's very unusual to see. Perfect backhand smash slash drive. That was really well played.
Good play. And well described.
Thank you. See, Stolzenbach really have to avoid these simple, easy errors. Because she's, at the moment, I think, playing the better of the two. And is deserving the lead.
That's in as well. And it's level pegging, 11 each.
11 all.
Well, that's proved to be a good smash.
12, 11.
Kirsty. She scored, I think, 3 or 4 points in that. Is okay. Everything is okay, but the execution was just simply too loose. It was enough pressure on it, so she had to run big time for that.
Yeah, I'm sure even Usain Bolt would have got to that one.
Service over. 13-12.
Yeah, but would he have had the racket skills?
No, probably not. I know he's a golfer.
Have West Indian umpire in Barbados.
Getting a hint here.
Service over. 13 all.
Well, she's adjusting well, fought back well. Well played. Very good.
Again, she's taking a big chance there. I think it was bold of her again to attack that one from the around the head position. And she actually followed up quite nicely, but the lift she played was a bit too flat and we also a little bit too short and got her into trouble straight away.
Girl here back in front. Oh dear, just couldn't get there quick enough.
16-14.
That's a little bit bad judgment in my book. She could play so many shots from that position and still win it. And she chose to play the most difficult one.
That one just wide as well. And suddenly.
14.
And the gap appears again. Oh, wow.
That's good. Excellent. That's a shot. Little bit of the same medicine. That's been one of Gilmour's good shots from the round of heads. Sideways to smash down the line, and here she got a little bit of her own medicine.
5 points in a row, this from Stolzenbach.
Good. Chances are we're going into a third set here for the first time in this tie.
19-14.
Six game points for Stolzenbach.
20 game points.
And a good run
40.
Of points for Stolzenbach.
It's long. Yeah, 8 points in a row to take that second set
second
for
Paddy's
Stolzenbach.
21-14. One game off.
And this one right in the balance now, because especially the way the Dutch girl ended that set. She's very high on confidence, and 21-14 she took it. One set all, 1 point all, don't forget.
Als je op haar voorhand speelt, probeer dan ietsje meer te richten, want ze speelt met haar voorhand bijna allemaal een harde crossbox. Ja? Rek het open.
En als je mixing with the body smashes, if you can, right? And then just take time a little bit more. Because at one stage she was winning a couple of points, you know, because okay, because you couldn't get the lens perfectly.
Thank you.
still going there. All right, and then a couple of times you move and the quick was very good as well, because then she doesn't have any point.
Court one, Court one, 20 seconds.
Stolzenbach back with the momentum right now. She ended the first set well. She carried it on through the second. And Gilmour, who was very confident after taking that first set, 21-16, is trailing now, albeit by 1 point.
She's playing the shot. She's actually not committing herself forward. She's already backtracking at the same time as when she's playing the shot. And that's why it's not coming over her. She knows. And then yet again, lots of crosses.
The pace.
The jump smashing between. Sometimes I feel she's using a lot of energy on these jump smashes, but they are really not that efficient. She's not getting from it what she wants, I think.
It's her favourite shot though, isn't it? That jump smash.
Yeah. She needs to time it a little bit better and place the shots a little bit better to get the full.
3-2.
Cross-court defence there, well played.
4-2.
The imbalance of the first two matches, it's nice to see a rather more evenly paired game.
Mm. I must say, I'm a little bit surprised it's this even. I have thought that Gilmour would, I wouldn't say win it comfortably, but let's say scores like 21-17, 21-18.
Well, yeah, we weren't surprised at what we saw in the first set, were we really? We were expecting more of the same, but right on the line.
5-4.
But they're still working to Stolzenbach's advantage this, because she's actually playing on what we consider to be the bad side of the court. And she's only down 5-4. So can she get in a situation where she's, let's say, possibly only 11-9 down?
Yeah.
She will be in a good position.
5-4.
Because, of course, at the interval, they swap sides in this set.
Very tight, but good coverage of that net, making sure that Stolzenbach is not getting away with that drop shot. Jump for the cross. Another defense by that.
Service over.
It's a Is it six, four. Shots she's using too much? She must learn to play that one down the line as well. You know, when she's coming up against better players, they will cover that one straight away and attack it.
In two minds, wasn't she, but made the right choice in the end. You said that's out. I have to say I thought it was. Kirsty certainly thought it was. Very close, that's a shot. That one's definitely out though.
Service over.
It's a nice backhand, very in nicely played. She should have possibly played it more flat as a drive rather than a high backhand. And that will ensure to keep the shot in.
Service over. 8-0.
We've seen Gilmour make some mistakes on that defense on the forehand side there. It's like she's snatching that shot and not really following the record movement through. Patty should be too annoyed by the situation on the 9-8 down. If it was me, I would have been very happy. But she just needs another point right here.
Service over.
She's standing in a very good position.
Draw after the first two brothers.
They played equally long. Oh, just a matter. And it's a close match. Seems it's all coming down to the two doubles at the end.
Well, 11-9 is the interval score.
Mortimer
suggesting 11-9, not necessarily a bad score for Paddy Stolzenbach, given the fact that she will now be playing on the other side of the court when they do resume.
Service over. 10-11.
Well, the This is going to be a close call.
It's obviously important for Patty to get a good start here, and she's got it. The first 2 points got the Dutch.
11-all.
So 11-all. And I think Gilmour is looking a little bit shaky in my book. Oh, that's a good shot. Really positive.
12-11.
Intercepting, going cross court. Good smash.
Perhaps
the decisive run, is it? After the break. Four points in a row from Stolzenbach. Gilmour needs to start producing. That's a start for her.
13.
Very nice shot. The reverse there. Very quickly played. And Patty was miles away from it.
Service over.
Not really having the luck here.
14.
It's just 12. Out on the sideline.
She needed it as well. I mean, the difference is only a point if you like, but 16-12 to 15-13 at this stage of the match.
That could have been decisive, that's for sure. Oh, luck in it for there.
14-15.
Look at that. That's a lucky shot. This is tight.
Yeah, nothing stops them back. Two with that, is there?
Just tumbling over. Another good shot there. That's a shot I would use now. It seems
16,
to be very effective.
14.
She's playing it well. She's into the match. It works for her. She's going to use that one a few times more. See if she can secure some points.
Service over. 15-16.
Well, this is a important moment, not just in this matchup between the two girls here, but also in the overall perspective of who's going to win this decisive level two match. So two doubles to come, the men's and women's doubles.
Another lucky one.
That was a lucky one, you say, or a really good tight net shot? Probably the latter. Okay. Yeah. So there we are, back level again, 16-all, just when it seemed that Stolzenbach was getting away. Gilmour, though, constantly trailing, isn't she, in the second part of the
17-16.
Of the set, since the interval, behind again. Brilliant.
Yeah.
Fabulous shot from Stolzenbach.
I think she's doing right when she's exploiting that forehand defense of Gilmour. That seems fairly suspect.
So 2 points from victory now. Let's see whether there's going to be some fighting 19. Spirit here from Gilmour. They've been on court 45 minutes. Oh, that's a gem.
I just said it, you know, exploit that side. She's a bit suspect that they've suddenly placed an absolute dream of the shot.
There.
I didn't get over.
What a point. I mean, she did so well to recover the situation. Then she slipped, yeah. Was out of it. Unfortunately for Stolzenbach, she couldn't get it back over.
No. This is a good shot. Here she's slipping, but it's not coming over. And her back foot is slipping and she can't move forward.
Well, it's back to 19-all. 19-16 up for the Netherlands.
If Cassie's losing this one, she will be thinking about this 19-16 lead for a long time.
She's sorted out that defensive forehand, hasn't she?
Yes.
And now she's got match point, having taken an incredible run here of points at just the right moment, four in a row. Oh, what a retrieval!
Another dive.
It's into extra points.
20
on. Probably an opportune moment for a break. Of course, the court needing to be mopped up. 20 points on. Can't say she's not giving it all, but it's match point for the first time now. First Stolzenbach here.
21-20.
She's certainly making Gilmour work, isn't she? But look at the powers of recovery tip. She was watching for a while as well. Here, look, she's looking. Now she's up, and then she's still quick enough to get across. Oh, I slid under the net.
Yeah, she was under the net. But that's not a mistake, though, all these days.
So match point, Netherlands.
Oh, going out. She was really lucky there. I'm telling you, hit the A board in the back.
Yeah, she didn't. She caught the face of Stolzenbach. Bang, right on the forehead. 21-0. It's a little short. And now it's second match point for Gilmour.
22-21.
What a contrast to the other two matches we saw.
It's all about composure, both sides. Good serve, good return. Attack.
Seven, seven.
Me, that's a good shot.
22-4.
And on they go. It is a good shot. Almost pulled it off, another winner there.
Goodness, guys.
Seven, seven.
This guy's in the smash there, he was slightly reversed.
23-22.
And that was enough to move the racket a little bit away from Stolzenbach.
Well, third match point then for Gilmour.
Yeah, look at that. Nice.
And that's it. Oh. It's just in. Gilmour, heart in mouth moment. Should have been it, was it, but just.
She had a complete open court, and she was just about to miss
match
it.
One by
look
Scotland,
at that.
21-16, 14-21, 24-22.
Relief, pure relief. Well, what a fabulous match. And it swung one way, then the other, and finally back into the path of Scotland's Kirsty Gilmour. 24-22 in the final set. It's Scotland 2, the Netherlands 1.